Hello, and welcome to the InfoZoom video series. My name is Stephen Pesklow. I am president of SoftLake Solutions, and today what I'd like to do is provide just an introduction to InfoZoom and a comparison to other common software tools. So first, as an agenda, I would like to provide a description of what is InfoZoom. I also like to ask or determine what makes InfoZoom different, and then also compare other software solutions. And typically we're asked about ACL or IDEA, Tableau or Excel, but others as well. So first, a little bit about InfoZoom and its history. Is it was created in the late 90s from an organization called the Fraunhofer Institute. It was a spin-off. Fraunhofer is the same organization that is that created MP3. It's a very commonly known organization in Europe, not so much in the United States, but it is that organization that created and spun off from for MP3. So the software itself is developed in Cologne, Germany, with and very, very broadly and very commonly used software solution. We have over 100,000 users worldwide, well over 2,000 clients, and the software is also available in 9 different languages. So it's a very robust, very often used software solution. So what we do from SoftLake Solutions is that we use it specifically in 3 areas: around audit data analytics, for fraud and criminal investigations, and then also for privacy and compliance. The software is used for many other different applications as well. So things like data quality and data monitoring, geospatial, which is actually really cool, using things like Google Maps or mapping technologies to provide another visualization to your analysis. Metadata analytics, as well as what's called list and label applications. So the advantages of InfoZoom, what makes it different? First of all, it's the unique visualization allows you to do a lot of analysis, a lot of different type of analysis that you typically would not get from other software solutions. It's an overview. The overview allows you to identify anomalies that we're commonly looking for in audits and in criminal investigations, as well as in privacy. So that visualization is very unique to the software. It's a what we call self-service business intelligence tool, which means that that is really intended for non-technical users. You can do a lot of your analytics without any support from IT or needing a DBA or other types of report writing skills. It also has a large number of analytical functions. So even though it is very easy to use, it is also very robust for people that want that analytical capabilities. It's a completely in-memory solution, and again, this is how it differs from other software, is that just the overall speed of analysis helps in InfoZoom. So if you go to InfoZoom, just if you're drilling into things, just the overall speed that you can see from the software, and that's much different because it's not going to a database; it's all completely in-memory. And like I mentioned, there is no database behind the scene. So what that does is allows us to do that overall analysis, again, without having the overhead of working with a database. And no formatting issues are common within InfoZoom. This is important when we're doing analysis in fraud or in privacy, because we're commonly working with data sets that we're not familiar with. And so if we're trying to compare, let's say, a 10 character code in one database, but then a 9 character code in another, sometimes that can be kind of difficult in other tools. Here, because it's all in memory, it really is quite easy to work with. It's also a very highly efficient technology. Just think again, going back to MP3, where we can really get tens of millions of transactions. We've actually seen as high as 54 million at one time, which is key. We're able to analyze data without having to do sampling, without having to partition your data, and really be able to see that large holistic view in a very visual way. And then lastly, you're able to join disparate or different data sources. And an example of this might be you would have an ERP system, you might have an AP system, an accounts payable system, and then you're able to bring in data. So you can bring in the ERP data into InfoZoom, again in memory, and bring in your AP data, again in memory, and able to join and link different data sources together. Another common application is maybe in one system you might have financial transactions, and then in another system you might have HR information. So one of the examples that a common case study is to be able to analyze financial transactions, and maybe you have an external data source of people who are recently deceased. So what you can do is you can grab data from your financial system and then also look at that file of recently deceased people. And we have had customers that look through their financial transactions like within the last quarter or so and were able to identify financial transactions that were recently done by deceased people, which is very interesting and obviously a potential case for fraud. So hopefully you enjoyed this this video series. Please let us know if you have any questions. Do subscribe to our YouTube videos and let us know if we can help. Otherwise, have fun with your InfoZoom analysis. Thanks.